Today we're talking about Brexit, a conflict that has been going on so long now that, honestly, I might be running out of jokes. It's been over 2 years since the referendum passed, and I know Britain has the tendency to stay in places long past the point they're supposed to, just as India, America, or half of the world, but it's getting ridiculous. Now, you probably know why I'm talking about Brexit today. Its name has recently been popping up on the third page of all of your newspapers again. So first, a quick last time on Brexit recap. Theresa May had negotiated a 585-page deal successfully with the EU that basically said, we'll stick to abiding by European Union regulations until we negotiate Brexit again a few years down the road. Except now, because we left, we won't have any input into what those regulations are. Basically, in leaving the EU, Britain somehow managed to find a way to have less sovereignty over their rules. This is why...
It's the defeat the entire UK Parliament was expecting. Theresa May's Brexit deal was rejected by 230 votes, the largest margin for a sitting government in the country's history.
Yeah, on January 14th, Great Britain truly became a United Kingdom to resoundingly reject this proposal. Brexiters were angry because, turns out, Britain isn't a big fan of being on the receiving end of taxation without representation. And on the other side, anti-Brexiters saw the looming renegotiations a few years out and said, "Nah, we want to stay in." Also, a whole Irish thing we'll get to in a bit. So it failed with everybody. Well, not everybody. I'm sure Theresa May's mom liked it. Probably made the fridge. But this left Great Britain looking down the barrel of a quickly coming hard Brexit deadline on March 29th if they didn't get anything negotiated. And if you haven't noticed, well, that's in 2 weeks. Last time I left you, Britain had voted down the EU negotiated deal, and the EU was saying they wouldn't renegotiate. It was looking like a waiting game to brace for impact. Well, that was the case with some very uninspiring headlines, like on February 8th when the UK negotiated citizens' rights in Norway, Ireland, and Liechtenstein in case of a no-deal Brexit, or when they did the same deal with Switzerland on February 25th. A hard Brexit was starting to feel less like the contingency plan and more like the plan. This is until...
British Prime Minister Theresa May has announced that she has won legally binding changes to overcome a roadblock in the UK's divorce deal with the European Union. And it comes hours before the British Parliament is due to decide the fate of Mrs. May's agreement and of Britain's departure from the EU.
Yes, in a hugely cinematic moment for British Parliament, just before the Parliament was going to re-vote on her proposal, because they liked it so much the first time, Theresa May announced three legal changes that she had gotten the European Union to accept. These three changes were all regarding Ireland, a country that answers the question, why don't more countries try imperialism with countries they're attached to? You see, half of Ireland, or Northern Ireland, is part of the United Kingdom, while the other half of Ireland, or the Republic of Ireland, is a part of the European Union. If Northern Ireland and the Republic of Ireland were to start using two separate sets of regulations on their goods, you'd need to put up some sort of barrier. You know, to prevent the flow of all those super dangerous products that are only approved for sale in France and the European Union. Do you see an Eiffel Tower here? This is Big Ben country. And you're welcome for not even attempting an accent right there. Now, this was pretty darn confusing to research, but since the Irish hate border walls more than Democrats, they were facing a problem. The solution? An Irish backstop. Basically, Great Britain will remain inside the customs union until a future technological solution can be found to create a frictionless border. Wow, 2 years and that's the best solution you came up with? Alright. The three legal changes that Theresa May secured from the EU were:
first, a joint instrument with comparable legal weight to the withdrawal agreement will guarantee that the EU cannot act with the intent of applying the backstop indefinitely.
Basically, and this is just Britain thinking they're the coolest thing since sliced bread, they were saying, yes, we'll stay in your customs union to keep this border thing open until we figure out something else better. But EU, if you intentionally obstruct the process because you just love having us in your customs union that much, we might have to walk. That actually covers the first 2 points. And the other point she secured was that this backstop would be provided as an insurance policy. If, miraculously, in the next 2 weeks, the EU and Great Britain don't just rally and come up with some sort of great solution. So back to Tuesday. We're just a few hours away from a second vote on Theresa May's proposal. And I imagine her running into Parliament in slow motion saying, "Wait! I have a new agreement for you to vote on. The deadline is coming. Everything's on the line. Cue the dramatic music."
Theresa May's Brexit deal has suffered another huge blow. British Parliament rejected her plan for the second time.
Okay, maybe we don't turn that one into a movie. For those of you keeping track of the time, this new deal got rejected on the 12th, and the Brexit deadline is on the 29th. At this point, Parliament's working like a college freshman with their paper due next week. Let me just start writing stuff down and see if my TA can turn it into coherent pieces of legislation that someone will actually accept. So what can you do? On the 14th, two ideas came up for vote. First, a second referendum. Basically, 2 years ago we heard
that the UK has voted out. The UK electorate has taken the historic decision to withdraw from the European Union after more than 40 years of membership.
Try not to sound too excited. So as an American viewing this, most of us ask, well, just hold a second referendum. It's like how Amazon asked me if I'm sure I want to buy those 3,000 ladybugs, rather than just give me a one-click order. It sounds awesome right now, but 2 days later when that buzz at my door isn't my doorbell, I'm probably going to want a chance to reverse what I've done. People who argue for a referendum say, this has clearly failed. Let's put it up to another vote and see if it's still what the people want. And that sounds reasonable, right? Well, opponents would say, Britain's veiled for this, so we can't back out now. And that sounds unreasonable until I put it into context. This would be similar to Americans looking at Donald Trump and saying, well, it's been 2 years and this just isn't working for us. Let's hold a vote right now, halfway through his term, to see if Americans really wanted to put Hillary Clinton in office. Even if you hate Donald Trump and still drive around with an "I'm with her" bumper sticker, that probably sounds like a terribly undemocratic idea. That's why
this First Amendment there requesting a delay to Brexit and a second referendum defeated by 334-285.
Yeah, on March 14th, that second referendum got shot down. So 2 weeks away from a deadline, no agreement, no second vote, what can you do besides crank up the Titanic theme and call your loved ones? Well, at the last second, Great Britain came together and did the impossible and the inevitable. They solved the problem. Well, almost.
MPs overwhelmingly backing a motion to try and extend Britain's planned departure from the EU. Brussels now has to sign off on the delay, which would last until June if the UK approves a deal in the coming days.
Oh, you guys, seriously, I'm running out of jokes here. Please do something besides vote to delay. This was announced on the 15th, also known as today, if I can rally to get the editing of this video done. I swear, who needs a second referendum when the only thing the government can agree on is, let's get back to this in a bit. Or, let's wait for a here-for-unknown technology to fix this border issue. So, I guess we're going to revisit this in June. Until then, feel a little urgency and carry on. Thank you, and that's definitely not all I have to say about that. Hello, YouTube. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan news, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the right of my head. Ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring, and give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching.